Good evening and welcome to each of you. I know the students and the teachers have been looking forward to this evening for quite some time, and we as parents have been too, so good to have each of you here. Part of the goal of HOPE Enrichment is to provide opportunity for students to be able to have activities and learning that they can't get at home, and that's part of what this evening is about tonight. So it's good to have each of you here. Psalms 33 tells us that praise is fitting, it's comely and beautiful for the upright, and so it's good to praise the Lord tonight. Two announcements before we get started. One is that for the HOPE Enrichment students and parents, there's a lost and found, I think, down the steps near the coat racks from things throughout the year. So you might want to check that. There's things there that are going to be confiscated by the church just shortly, so you better check that. Second, let's continue to pray for the King family. Johnny is steadily improving slowly each day, and so let's continue to pray. One prayer request right now is that his face would be healed, his fractures on his face, that he wouldn't need surgery. So let's continue to pray for the King family. Let's pause for a moment of prayer. Dear Father, we thank you for the opportunity to gather here and to hear our children and grandchildren sing and praise you this evening. Father, thank you for the rich blessings that you showered upon us. And Father, tonight we pray that you would accept our praises. We want to honor you in all that we do. Bless the leaders here this evening. Bless the students as they sing. And as we listen, that we would worship you. In Jesus' name, amen. Take your song books, the hymnal, the worship books, and turn to song number 102. To God be the glory. 102.
To God be the glory, great things he hath done, so thank you.
Certainly, we do have more than 10,000 reasons, don't we? We'd like to lift an offering at this time. And so if the ushers could make their way forward. In the meantime, let's turn to song number 151. The offering will benefit, go towards the work of costs incurred with HOPE Enrichment. And if you'd like to make out a check, you can make it out to HOPE Enrichment. So let's sing 151. And the ushers, you can come forward and begin to take the offering.
Marvelous grace of our loving Lord, grace that exceeds our sin and our guilt, yonder on Calvary's mount that bore, there the blood of the Lamb was spilled.
Thank you.
Hi, Michael. Didn't know you were going to be here.
Oh, yeah. I just love helping with missions.
Hey, Grace. I haven't seen you for a while.
I know. I've just been so busy. Is your sister doing any better? Some. Her foot is finally starting to heal.
Hi, Michael. Hello, Miss Finch. Welcome, everyone.
Terribly sorry. Got stuck in a meeting. I hope we're not late.
You're just in time, Mr. and Mrs. Davenport. We are just about to get started.
Go right ahead.
Welcome to our first missions and outreach meeting. We have I've asked our secretary here to write all of your ideas and suggestions down. Oh, and if you want, there's coffee and donuts over in that corner. Just help yourself.
I'm so honored that you asked me to help with this project. I just love the idea of helping poor needy people.
Did you have any ideas, Ms. Finch?
Well, yes. I was up late last night thinking what we could do. I just read an article the other day about these poor Austrian people that are starving because there's a famine in Austria.
Don't you mean Australia?
What?
Never mind.
I'm all for helping needy people.
Just think what it would be like if we could help a whole bunch of needy people.
Statistics show that there are far too few people equipped to help all those needy people. I think if we want to make a difference, we need to start training workers.
Did you get that idea written down, Ms. Secretary?
Yes, Mr. Chairman.
Shouldn't we work on the needs around us before we focus on foreign missions?
We should look into programs that will give our church a good name and also more publicity. Don't you agree, dear?
Yes, dear.
Okay, we can try to keep that in mind.
What kind of needs do you want to help? There are lots of different things we could do.
What about starting a Christian school in Africa? It'd be so hard to be a Christian and not know how to read.
That's a good idea. Who else?
There's more urgent needs around us. I'm sure you all heard about that terrible hurricane that ripped through Haiti. People down there need help quickly.
Helping people is a really good way to show that we care about them and that God loves them.
So you're in favor of the idea, Don?
Which idea? I can't get them all straight.
I believe we were discussing the crisis in Haiti.
I don't know. It seems like there's already a lot of groups helping in Haiti. I think we should pick somebody more needy.
More needy?
Maybe we can wait to choose until we all share all of our ideas. Then we could vote on one.
That's an excellent idea. Don't you agree, dear?
Yes, dear.
Sounds good to me. I think if we want to help with an emergency situation, we should help the refugees in Greece and Iraq. They really need to hear the gospel story.
That idea is too big. Where would we even start? Refugees are too needy.
Too needy? Don't you think God is big enough?
I didn't say that. Of course, God is big enough. But there are only a few of us here, and our church isn't that big either.
What if we try to think of a mission that a member of our church helps with?
Don't we already financially support them?
I was thinking of helping a mission, not just a person.
But who? There's Avery Smith, who's helping to smuggle Bibles. Oh, and it's Jennifer Peters, who works with the medical aid in South America.
Don't forget my cousin serving in New York City.
How many ideas are there so far, Ms. Secretary?
There are 8 ideas, sir. Only 8? It had to be more than that.
How far are we going to take some of these? I mean, what all is it going to include? Are we just going to donate money, or are we going to gather supplies and recruit volunteers?
That is what we have to decide here as a group.
Statistically speaking, organizations work better when each person uses their abilities.
That's exactly right, Blake. I can donate money much easier than just going myself. And Mrs. Davenport's nerves haven't been very strong lately, have they, dear?
No, dear.
Are we ready for a vote, or are there more ideas to discuss?
But we've only started talking about all the possibilities.
Maybe we should start with the first idea. I'll see how we can help with the famine in Austria unless we have more details. You still have the article, Ms. Finch?
Yeah, but I don't know if we can read it.
Why not?
I think I was drinking my coffee where I read the article and the coffee spilled all across the page.
Doesn't really matter anyway. I remember reading that article 7 or 8 years ago.
You mean we could have tried to help needy people when it might not be needy now?
Well, I like it better than Blake's idea of helping people help people.
I have to agree with Ms. Finch. How do you help people help people? Does that mean giving the pastor a raise so that he preaches better sermons? That was just a joke.
What I was suggesting was to teach people how to be better missionaries. How can a person help others unless he has the right tools?
That just sounds like a lot of boring work. I thought this means we plan exciting things.
Mission work is more than just excitement. It's changing people's lives that matters.
I really want to do something important, not just donate more money.
But you do realize that all of these projects would need financial support if we did them.
Of course we know that, Mr. Davenport, but what I think Grace meant is that she would like to do more than just donate more money.
I'm willing to help too, but I am not going to go to Africa and start a mission I'm not passionate about.
Yeah, and I don't really want to go to Haiti either.
I'm confused. Why are we going to Africa?
We aren't going to Africa, Ms. Finch.
Guys, why are we arguing over this? If we all have our own ideas, why don't we just do them ourselves?
Statistically speaking, this meeting was a waste of my time.
I thought this was going to be fun.
I think I'm going to go somewhere else where my money is more appreciated.
How can each of you get much of anything done by yourselves? Can't we stay and work together for the kingdom of Jesus?
And one by one they ran away with their made-up minds to leave it all behind. And the light began to fade in the city on the hill. But it was the rhythm of the dancers that gave the poets life. It was the spirit of the poets that gave the soldiers strength to fight. It was the fire of the young ones. It was the wisdom of the old. It was the story of a poor man that's needed to be told. One by one will we run away with our made-up minds to leave it all behind. As the light begins to fade in the city on the hill, the city on the hill. Calling still, come home to the city on the hill. Come
Yes. I dine with you today. I come, Zacchaeus, I come to your house, come lead the way.
Zacchaeus, he gave a cheer. Yeah.
Yes.
Well, that's a fitting prayer to end our evening on and to end our school year on. So we want to thank everyone who had a part tonight, each of the students and each of the song leaders and teachers, and particularly to George for organizing the evening. Thank you to Ruth Ann and Kay for all your hard work this year and everyone that had a part. And for you parents and grandparents, some of you behind the scenes, making it possible for us to continue homeschooling. So the Lord bless each of you, and let us stand for prayer dismissal. Father, thank you for the great gift of our children, and we thank you for the good plans that you have for them. Now we ask your blessing upon them, and as we part for another summer, Father, that we would seek to do your will, that you would bless us as we seek to honor you. Be with and bless each of the teachers and group mothers and those who have helped this year with HOPE. And Father, now dismiss us with your blessing, we pray in Jesus' name, amen. You are dismissed.
Good. So y'all can get started.